I have this Hayden SuperVac Premier, and it wouldn't start. So when you plug the vac hose in, flip the switch on, the vacuum wouldn't start. I said, boy, what's up with that? So did a little troubleshooting, took the lid off. The lid is held on by 6 screws. Make sure you unplug your unit first. And I did this a couple years ago, but I thought I would just share with you what I did to fix it. So the first thing you'll notice inside this unit is that there's a control board. The little standard control board is right here. And on that control board, there's normally a transformer that's mounted on it. And after a little bit of troubleshooting, I figured out that, boy, the real expensive part of the vacuum, which is the motor, worked. But for some reason, the control board wasn't working. And so the control board looked like it was around $100. And I thought, well, before I throw $100 at this, let me see what's really wrong with it. Because there just aren't that many components on it that could go wrong. There's a circuit breaker. And then there's a relay. And the relay controls the motors. And that's really about it. So I figured it out. It was the transformer that's mounted on the control board. And I didn't have a camera at that time, but I did take some pictures. So you're going to see some pictures of the modification I did to this to essentially make this work. To make a long story short, I added a little toggle switch right here. That gives me on-off in my garage. So I can use any vac hose I want. So I can just put any old vac hose in there, whether it's a smart hose or not. Throw the vac hose in, flip the on-off switch on, and it works. But what you'll see here is this transformer. So in a nutshell, I took the transformer that was on the control board completely off, and I couldn't find a printed circuit board mounted transformer. So I just went and found I had a loose old scrap 24-volt AC transformer, which in my case, this is exactly what I needed. I needed 24 volts AC, and not a lot of power, but this standard 24 volts is used on your thermostat wiring, and some doorbells use that 24-volt transformer. So they're very inexpensive, and it's likely you might even have one lying around the house. You can see that the yellowish wires here are the output of the transformer. So this is 24 volts AC, and you can see, I'll show you with the still pictures that I took when I was doing this a couple years ago, I'll show you where that connects. And then the hot side of the transformer, which is this black and white wire, they go to those two spots right there. And when you see these still photographs, you'll be able to see where I connected those, and you'll be able to do the same. So hope this helps you guys out a little bit before you throw $100 plus at a new control board. If you can figure out whether it's just the transformer on the control board, there's a way to take the old transformer out, just unsolder it, and then connect 4 wires in the place where the original 4 transformer connections were, and use this external transformer. Just got it mounted on a little bracket, and it's worked very nicely for me. So this unit has a solid covered lid, plastic. My other unit that's inside my house, which does most of the house, not my garage, has a clear lid on it. It's pretty cool. You can see straight down into it. So both the units are the same age, but this particular unit died sooner than the other one. And hopefully if this helps you out and you save $100 or so, give me a thumbs up, like, I appreciate it.